Have you heard about social feeds and how it helps to grow your e-commerce platform? Basically, a social feed is an updated list of content that is posted by the account user regarding the latest updates. So, the role of social feed in e-commerce is build brand awareness, sell products, improve customer support. Hi, I'm Achal. Here, we will be checking out the functionality of social feed for WooCommerce plugin. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webkul.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog section, from where you can check the features and configuration and get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now, let's move back to our video. So, let's have a quick eye on the key highlights of this plugin. Instagram social feed for WooCommerce is the perfect way of advertising the products by social media. The store owner can able to add Instagram feeds on different pages along with the hashtags. Also, it allows better understanding of the products with the images in Instagram feeds. So, let me take you to the backend configuration there. And before proceeding ahead, I would request you to do subscribe our channel and do hit the bell icon button to get more updates. Now, as you can see, I have successfully logged into the backend of WooCommerce. So, let's have a quick discussion like how you can manage the configuration settings from the backend. As here, you can see, I am on the dashboard. And to move further with the Instagram shop feeds, you need to navigate into the left navigation, and here you will find an option of Instagram shop feeds. After that, you need to tap over the settings button and it will redirect you to a new page, that is Instagram and Facebook. In order to configure these platforms with your WooCommerce website, you need to fetch the Facebook app ID and app secret key from your Facebook account there. And for this, you must have a Facebook developer account as well. As I have already created the Facebook developer account, so let me take you to the backend of Facebook. As you can see here, I am on the backend of my Facebook developer account, and here inside this, you will get an option of my application. Now, after that, you need to tap over my application button, and accordingly it will display you the result along with the all application which is listed earlier. In order to create your new app, you need to tap over that particular button, that is create app. After that, you need to select and type over here, as I am choosing here the business. And next, along with that, you need to also write down the app name as well, as here I am adding a new app, that is new app for WooCommerce. Along with that, you need to also provide your contact email address, and after that you just need to tap over that particular create app button and it will ask you to re-enter your Facebook password. Here, you need to re-enter your password and after that, hit the submit button. Now, you can see this application is successfully registered. Now, you need to enter inside this particular application, and for this, do press the My Application button. Now, it will provide you a complete list of all the registered application. As you can see here, we have created this application, new app for WooCommerce. Now, for the further settings, you need to enter inside this application. And here, it will redirect you to a new page, and accordingly, you need to add some products over there. First, you need to add the Facebook login product. So, here, I am just scrolling a little down and you will find this particular option like Facebook login for business. In order to move ahead, you need to tap over that particular button, that is setup. and it will redirect you to a new page, and accordingly you can also able to add redirected URLs as well if you want. And after that, tap over the save changes button, and this application or this product is successfully saved. Now moving back, we need to add another product, that is Instagram Graph API. And inside this application, you will get an option of Instagram Graph API as well. Here, the same process you need to follow, which we have followed inside the Facebook login business account. So I'm just click on this setup button and it will redirect you to a new page along with some permissions and features. So I have added two of the products successfully. And now for the further process, if you want to fetch the live API, then you need to go through with the permissions and features policies as well of the Instagram Graph API. As you can see, we do have multiple lists on this screen. Now, next we are moving ahead with the retrieve secret application key and secret key access token of this plugin. So for this, as you can see over the screen, we do have an option of settings, and inside the settings you will get an option of basic. So you need to click on that particular basic button and it will redirect you to a new page along with app ID and app secret key. These app ID and app secret key will be required at the time of configuration settings inside your WooCommerce website. Now moving ahead, I will going to show you the backend configuration settings of the WooCommerce. Here inside the left navigation, you will find an option of Instagram shop feed, and along with that, multiple options we are having: Instagram shop feeds, add Instagram tags, settings and support and services. For the Facebook configuration section, you need to click on the settings option and it will display you the result as Instagram and Facebook. Here, in order to connect your Facebook developer account with your WooCommerce website, you need to fill out the required information like Facebook app ID and secret key along with the Facebook access token as well. And these details you will get from your Facebook developer account. As I have shown you earlier in this video, you will get these details like app ID and app secret key from your Facebook backend. Now, if you want to fill out this information manually, then you can do the same. And once you integrate your Facebook account, then it will auto fetch this Facebook app ID and app secret key accordingly. After filling out these details, you need to click on the save settings option, and accordingly it will display you a settings saved pop-up over the screen. Once you're done with the Facebook settings, then you need to go with the Instagram flow. And here, once you tap over the Instagram button, then you will find an option of carousel view and list view. You can choose a single view from the drop down there. Now you need to tap over the Instagram add tags as well. Once you click on the Instagram tag, then a new window will come up where you will be redirected to add the new tag over the Instagram. And here you will find multiple options like Instagram hashtag, Instagram linked products along with hashtag visibility and priority. Now here I am assigning a particular tag as I am creating a new tag with the name furniture, and here I am adding the products. You can add multiple products as well. Now the question arises, can we assign multiple products to the hashtag? How it is helpful? Yes, you can assign multiple products to the hashtag. It helps the store owner to increase the revenue of the store. So here I am going to show you how you can assign multiple products to the particular hashtag. As here you can see, I am assigning multiple products to this particular hashtag, and here I am choosing multiple products from the drop down there. After choosing the products here, I need to enter the hashtag visibility as well, like where you want to display these hashtags on the shop page, dedicated page, or on the product page. Here I am selecting the product page. If you want, then you can select the multiple pages as well. Next, hashtag priority you need to select over here, as I am assigning the first priority. And next, you are having an option of status. From here you can enable or disable this particular Instagram tag. Now we have covered the complete information, like we have filled out the required information. After that, you need to click on the save hashtag button and it will going to appear on the complete list of the Instagram hashtags. Now, to check that particular complete list, you need to navigate inside the left navigation, and here you will find an option of Instagram shop feeds. As you can see here, we have created this hashtag as of now, that is furniture. And for this, if you want to edit that particular hashtag, then you just need to click on the edit option and it will redirect you to a new page from where you can also able to fetch the images from the Instagram. So here I am tapping over the fetch images button and it will display you the complete images from where you can import the images regarding the furniture as well. As here I have selected multiple images, and after selecting the images you need to click on the import option. And the process is going to start and all the images is imported successfully. Now, this way you can able to manage the configuration settings from the WooCommerce backend. So let me take you to the customer flow, like how it will going to appear over the product page, how you can able to manage the Instagram feed hashtags on the product page there. Now, as you can see, I am on the customer panel, and here I will going to show you where those particular hashtag will going to appear on which product page. As here you can see over the screen, we do have multiple products listed over here, and here I am going to show you where I have attached those hashtags, as I have selected that particular Ninja product at the time of creation of hashtag, and those particular hashtag will be going to appear on the bottom of this particular product. As you can see, featured post of buyers from Instagram, and here you can able to see those tags along with the images. This way you can able to manage, or you can able to create the multiple hashtag along with multiple products. So that's all about the social feed for WooCommerce plugin. If still you are having any kind of concern or queries, you can reach us at support@webkul.com, or you can also raise a ticket from webkul.uvdesk.com. I hope you liked our video. If so, then please give us a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day ahead.